tried a cruise line that offers premier service and world-class amenities on one of a fleet of four smaller classic ships. And we're taking you with us so you can get an overview of an Azamara cruise that provides exotic itineraries, exclusive access, and unique experiences. We want you to have an idea of what to expect, to see what kind of service you'll receive, and discover what types of adventures you might have. We're going to take you for an overview of our entire cruise, sharing as much as we can. We'll show you how we got from Rome to our port. Embarkation.
Boarding.
Excursions. Dining. Beverages.
Strawberry daiquiri.
Entertainment. And special events. And finally, debarkation in Venice. On an at-sea day, we'll tour the Onward. And we'll show you around our veranda suite. We'll visit the countries of Italy, Montenegro, and Croatia. And we'll bring you along to each port of call to share just a little taste of our experience so we don't spoil all of the wonders for you. So whether you're just learning about Azamara or you're already booked, we hope we can help you be more excited and prepared for what might just be a trip of a lifetime or the start of a new passion.
Good morning, everyone. Nathalie and I are all packed up with our bags, and we're headed to Rome Termini Station, and we'll be heading to the port of Civitavecchia. But it's a beautiful day. Looks like it's gonna be another 30-degree day here in Rome. We've really enjoyed our stay, even though it was super fast and wish we had more time. The platform for this was platform 27, and it is probably the third most far from the actual terminal entrance, so it's a long distance to walk. And if you're mobility challenged, get here early so you have lots of time to walk it.
The train is clean and comfortable, and there's lots to look at along the way. Allow about an hour for the train to get from Rome to port.
All right, so we've made it to Civitavecchia at the train station. Once you get at the train station, you come out the doors, you go to the right, and there's gonna be a bus lineup. Show your tickets to get on the bus. And we're gonna be heading to our cruise. So we are going to be sailing on the Azamara Onward. Hopefully, maybe 10, 15 minutes away. And there we go. The bus ride was all of 5 minutes once we got through a little bit of traffic. And there's our little ship. We are all checked in. Pretty straight ahead process. You get greeted. They have bottles of water for you and a couple of little snacks.
After check-in, you can relax in the waiting area for your assigned boarding time.
Hi. We're boarding.
Good morning.
As we boarded the ship, we were greeted by a friendly crew for security check.
By a short safety briefing.
Hello.
We were welcomed aboard by each crew member we passed and provided guidance on where we were going.
Good morning.
While Onward is certainly not a mega cruise ship, it's not small. Azamara has four similar ships. On this one, the maximum guest count is 684 in 278 staterooms. And there are 408 crew and staff to look after those guests. There are 5 restaurants and 8 bars and lounges. Azamara offers a refreshing, always included base fare. There's a variety of dining options, including room service. Gratuities and a base list of drinks are also included.
Mandatory safety briefing.
Azamara hasn't moved to a technology-based safety briefing. Rather, they have a simple small group presentation in the cabaret lounge.
Safety drill completed. We're now on the 9th floor, and we're at the Windows Cafe. We're just beside it, and we're going to be booking our specialty dining.
Not long after safety briefing, an announcement was made that our rooms were ready. Azamara does their best to make special occasions more special.
Cheers.
Fortunately, we packed a change of clothes with our carry-on, so we relaxed on the pool deck and listened to the band. couple of beverages later, our bags were delivered and it was time for sail away.
Started our sail.
They were beautiful views in each direction I looked.
No idea what I'm having to drink.
As golden hour set in, it made for a gorgeous sail away.
We're just passing an MSC ship, and it's literally eclipsing us.
Looking around as we passed the last few docked ships, we began to understand what sets this cruise line apart.
So just up ahead, the final boat in the row, that's the Celebrity Reflection, which was our first cruise we ever took. This is our first Azamara. So far, we're just departing, and we're already loving it, so it's been great.
The sun set on our first day, and that evening, the crew presented us a welcome aboard show. We made our way to the cabaret lounge, where we met our cruise director.
I'm Eric, I'm your cruise director. I hail from Toronto, Canada.
Eric detailed the itinerary, and then a breakdown of who was on board and the staff. And we were given just a little sample from the entertainers of what to expect.
We've just come out of the Welcome Aboard show with all the cast that does all of the shows on the ship. And my God, they're all very talented.
Well, that's day one over. So let's have a look at our first port of call.
We dine on room service breakfast after waking up to the beautiful sight of Sorrento. Such a pretty spot to see from the water. We stop at a cafe for a latte, Americano, and pain au chocolat.
Then to the cabaret again to check in for our excursion.
Good morning, everybody. Natalie and I are up early, had our breakfast on the balcony, and now we're into our tender. We're heading off to Pompeii for the day.
The tender doubles as one of the ship's lifeboats, and the trip is a short, comfortable one.
So we're off of our tender. We're just waiting for the tour to start. Very quick, very easy. Considering we're on our way, everything moves very nicely, smoothly, and quickly. So now we're transferring to a larger tour bus.
It took almost an hour 30 to reach Pompeii, only 25 kilometers away. Seeing Pompeii again was amazing. Unfortunately for John's first visit, it was crowded, and I felt it took a little away from his experience. Our guide Sabina was excellent. I found her engaged the whole time and informative. As it is my second visit, I discovered they've made new finds over the years, and I enjoyed seeing them.
That's pretty much Pompeii.
I want you to know one thing.
In a rush.
The other statues.
I could easily spend the rest of the day here. Now we got a 2-hour trek back to the boat, I guess, or I guess we're gonna head back to Sorrento. But this is just quick in and out on the tour. Our guide was just mentioning that she says it's not actually very busy today, so I can't imagine.
After a slightly quicker trip back, we were dropped in town.
We're back in Sorrento now. We're just getting off the bus. We're gonna walk down to the core from the bus parking spot.
Thanks.
We have a couple of hours on our own.
The streets were bustling with activities and tourists.
We're gonna see if we can find some liqueur called limoncello. It's the local delicious drink.
Limoncello is an Italian lemon liqueur and is produced in this region. It's usually served chilled and as an after-dinner drink.
So we're at a limoncello shop. Limonaro. We've been around since 1905, so we're gonna buy a few bottles. Oof, I just had some limoncello. It's got a good bite to it. So there's all kinds of lemon trees lining the road here that we're walking on.
It gets more sun, so the fruit gets...
Oh, yeah. I'm trying to find a snack so we won't eat too much. Tour, because you depart so late and it takes so long to get there, you're in Pompeii during lunch and you're not back in Sorrento where it's like after 2 o'clock. I don't know if the timing's quite right because there's really no food in Pompeii because it's an archaeological dig.
Delicious. Limoncello spritz.
Pompeii is stunning. Incredible how amazing and preserved it is. I feel like the tour that we took with the company, it could have left earlier in the day so we got to see more or had more free time. That's it for Sorrento. We're all done. Back at the dock, and our tender is here. Another amazing day. All right, so we're going for a nice meal tonight. We're doing the chef's table, and they're holding that at the Prime Sea restaurant.
I thought the chef's table was quite nice. With only 5 people at the table, it sure felt special. We were having the Italian menu, and the food was great. Everything was fresh and delicious. I really enjoyed the sommelier for each wine pairing, and they were all amazingly tasty.
For the evening's entertainment, we first met the captain, and then the singers and dancers treated us to a disco revival called Groove Tonight. We were impressed with what they could do in a small venue.
So the Windows Cafe this morning for breakfast, it's a buffet, and it's about 9 o'clock, not very busy. Outside is full, so if you want to be eating outside, then maybe get up a little bit earlier.
We found the buffet to have a good variety and appeared to cater to a broad group. Everything always looked fresh and tasted good. Breakfast was fairly similar with slight substitutions, while lunch and dinner varied from day to day.
We're gonna be a little piggy pants here.
After a little breakfast, we strolled the promenade and enjoyed some of the peaceful views.
Greetings from the field of
You will notice one theme throughout the ship, a lack of crowds. Deck 9 is where the pool is located, and there's usually a crew member around to offer drinks as you relax. The pool bar, of course, offers friendly and quick service as well.
It's 11:30 right now. We're up on the pool deck. Pool's not packed. You can find a chair, and it's just relaxing.
There are 11 decks in total. We're going to head now to Deck 5 in the cabaret.
Waiting for the numbers to be called. That's the winning card. Apparently, she may consider taking.
The cabaret is multi-use. During the day, there can be games like bingo or guest speakers to provide information about an upcoming port or services.
Connections, and you can still see some of them today.
So something I seen the first time on Disney cruises was people would decorate their doors, and it looks like some people like to do that here on Azamara as well.
Next, let's check out our stateroom, close to the middle of the ship. Our first impressions were very clean, comfortable, with simple decor and a serviceable layout. Our veranda was an acceptable size. It's accessed by a sliding door that takes just a little effort to open and close. We were thankful that there was a standard height table, which made room service perfect. Not big, not small. The water closet, toilet, or loo is a decent size, and it covers most things you would expect from a boutique hotel. Fresh towels and a standard amenities kit. And very clean. The only elephant in the room are the famous shower curtains, which feel dated and can get a little clingy. The shower itself felt large enough for an average-sized adult and had plenty of pressure and steamy hot water. All in all, a good washroom experience. There was literature in the room that covers excursions and other information that you could refer to.
We have a veranda suite. Our room is number 7057 on the Onward.
When it comes to power, they have you covered. There's a little bit of everything throughout the suite.
So yeah, great options. There is a safe in the room.
And above that is a laundry bag.
The refrigerator is not particularly stocked. There's a little bit of water. And then you got four drawers right below that. And then the closet area has plenty of hangers. If you're a big packer with lots of clothes or anything, you may not have quite enough. You could probably call down and ask for more. But there's plenty in here, and there's lighting, which is really nice. Storage below, and we put our bags underneath the bed, tons of room underneath the bed. Every day, water in the room. There's water when you're disembarking as well for your excursions. They do have beach towels. You use them, and when you come back from your excursion, if you've gone to the beach, you can just leave them on the floor, and your attendant will look after them.
The included laundry is on deck 7. Heads up though, we did notice that some passengers like to spread one wash load across many dryers.
Elevators work really well. Never really have to wait very often for anything. It may move quickly.
The lower decks have some of the ship's services, and it's a good place to go if you have questions or need assistance.
Guest relations is on deck 4. Deck 5 is where all the shopping and everything is. And the little cafe for getting your Americanos in the morning.
From the cafe, next we'll move forward from midship, deck 5, towards the den.
and just relaxing in the piano lounge.
The lounge is also where you will find future cruises and the excursions counter.
Okay, we're looking at the cruise again menu. As you never know.
Moving forward still brings us back to the cabaret lounge, where passengers can gather for presentations, learn the required safety and muster station information, check in for shore excursions, and of course see some entertainment. Okay, let's talk about food. We'll start by going back to deck number 9.
So this is the Windows Cafe, which is basically the buffet. Moments after sitting down, a young man brought me lovely beverage.
Delicious.
Basically, it's a buffet. There's a variety, and it's all good and tasty.
We noticed that regular juice, if you order just regular orange juice or something, it seems to be very thin or very watered down. We found if you go to the juice bar and ask for an orange juice, or if you go to a bar, sometimes it's a much better quality.
Moving outside by the pool deck.
Having a big juicy burger at the patio. Oh, yeah.
The patio covers a good range of the basics, as well as sandwiches, salads, and more. And last of the lighter fare is the Mosaic Cafe.
We didn't buy a drinks package. We are just going with what is included on board, and we have been absolutely fine. We found plenty to drink on the regular list. If you are a boozer and you like to have fancy drinks, then yeah, go for it, man. But beer-wise, they have Carlsberg on tap, and then Beck's. And then there is a couple other ones. You can get Bud Light. You can get a non-alcoholic one called O'Doul's, which I've never had before. No need to go and get something fancy. And for me, I just would get a drink from each of the countries that we're in and get something local.
Let's jump to the evenings now and have a peek at the restaurants that are available. Starting with the Discoveries restaurant, which is included for all passengers.
We're in the Discoveries restaurant, which is like the big venue at the aft of the boat. And we're just looking at the menu and we're going to order up in a second. Looking at the New York Strip.
Alternatively, there's Aqualina, a specialty restaurant where you can enjoy authentic Italian dishes.
We're at Prime C right now. Everything's so delicious, we keep forgetting to video everything and show you what's going on. But yeah, it's pretty good. The tiny cinnamon sugar donuts. Mm. Sweet Jesus. So Prime C, I'm in.
Lastly, exclusive to the Onward right now is the Atlas Cocktail Bar. Other services include the Sanctum Spa, a fitness center, there's a card room on deck 10, right beside the living room lounge, even a small library for some quiet time. And evenings, it can turn into a little nightclub.
So there is a photographer on board, and it looks like he did snap a picture or two of us. Another fabulous night of entertainment after a day of hanging out around the pool.
Yeah, great.
And I'm done.
Of a smaller ship like Onward
to go through that.
Is the ability to access unique locations and sail right up to their doorstep.
For disembarking, and off we go into KOTOR.
I really appreciated walking off the ship just steps away from the gates. And if you are a cat person, you're gonna love it here. The city is absolutely gorgeous, and if you like, you can climb the steps to the fortification on top.
Our ship is here this evening until 10, that's when it departs. We're doing our white knight event this evening on board. What is it now, like 4 o'clock, 4:30? And it's starting to clear out, so it's kind of hitting that nice emptiness hour where it's just the people that are left that are staying here in the town. Back, we just have a nice cool towel waiting for us. I'm now currently sitting at the Windows Cafe on the outside of the terrace. And here we are in KOTOR Bay. Tonight is the white night. The entire deck is full of people dressed in white.
As we sailed away with a full moon and the KOTOR lights behind us, we were treated to live music with a range of hits, a buffet, and dancing. People had fun into the night while we called it to get some rest for the next day.
Good morning, everyone. Today we are in Croatia and we're on our way to Dubrovnik. But this city looks incredible at a distance, so we're looking forward to getting our Dubrovnik on. We actually get brought in right to the old city, whereas larger boats, they will dock further down the road and have to be brought in by shuttle bus. While we're waiting, we'll just talk about how inside everything's pretty expensive. If you wanted a map of the downtown area, I think it was about €7 to pick one up down there. But if you just go outside that gate where we're sitting right now, there's a little tourist booth and there are free maps of the area that gives you everything you need to know right there.
Dubrovnik is the land of Game of Thrones in all its splendor.
Shame, see? The shame, see? So these are the steps where the Walk of Shame started.
A city filled with history that we want to explore more of one day.
So we're back now on the ship. Now we're down in the piano bar, which is called the Den on the Onward. And then they're going to be calling deck by deck for people to board tenders again, and then we'll be heading back into town or towards a fortress.
At this time, we are now calling.
It was just a short wait in the lounge with a drink. And then we were summoned to the cabaret and on our way.
Background, the Onward.
It was an absolutely enchanted evening as the tender brought us into the marina by the old city gates.
Lovely boat ride over. Really nice they arranged this boat parcel. The drummer makes me feel like they're gonna take us to a platform with a bunch of posts and line us up.
Our procession walked along the old stone streets and past the impressive walls while our ship was glowing in the water just offshore. Next, we climbed candlelit stairs up into a corner fort.
Just as another side note, dress code-wise, I decided tonight I just wasn't up for having to wear a collared shirt and any kind of pants, so I'm wearing jeans and a t-shirt this evening. So even though it's a special evening, nobody judges you. Not that I ever really worry about it. And there, basically, there's white wine, there's red wine, and water, and champagne. So I think anything over and above that, you'd probably end up paying for
it. Azamazing this evening, as far as the locals are concerned.
Our Azamazing evening was a selection of local artists. There were musicians, dancers, singers, and traditional performers that gave us a proud display of their heritage.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for your wonderful hostess.
Very exciting performance, full of very nice entertainment. Beautiful young people dancing and singing and all around fun.
After the performance, we were guided back along the streets to our tender for a lovely trip back to our ship.
The next morning, we sailed peacefully past remnants of the Second World War and into Šibenik.
So it's a little more industrial of a port. Moon's out this morning, though. Nice weather, it's supposed to go up about 28 degrees, but no tenders today, so that's nice.
Our excursion takes us approximately 16 kilometers from Šibenik. Today's destination, the Krka National Park.
Home to a stunning collection of crystal clear cascading waterfalls.
We're gonna wander the little town for a bit and then head back to the ship at a decent time because we're actually out of the port by 6 tonight.
Šibenik was a lovely port. We visited some small shops and wandered the streets before returning to the ship for a 6 p.m. departure. We enjoyed our cruise through the channel and waved to other ships as we passed.
my immediate impressions of Trieste is that it is a much more living city. It's less tourist. There is tourism, but people live here. You can tell. They're moving around and making their days. I'm just going to take a picture of some wisteria here. Look at this.
Trieste is a vibrant city.
What a beautiful town. Just stunning. But busy. We think there's a fort this way.
We started exploring the city in search of some history and found some forts, churches, and Roman ruins. And it's probably not the best place to wear heels for exploring.
Wow. Well, Trieste is beautiful. Lots of people at restaurants, wandering around, doing their jobs. And we haven't seen, if any, very many touristy little shops.
Next, it was back to the ship so we could pack. Tomorrow, we arrive in Venice and wrap up our very first Azamara cruise.
So we're back from Trieste. We're gonna get some lunch and have a couple drinks, and we're gonna relax for the rest of the day because we are pooped from this week. And tomorrow, we gotta leave the ship in the morning and find our Airbnb in Venice. So that's gonna be a whole interesting adventure on its own.
The water right now in Fusina, but here's what it looks like right now.
So we're on a shuttle bus now. We're down at the Fusina port. Then I guess they're taking us to the main terminal. So we're still not clear if that's here on the mainland or over on the island.
Well, it was a heck of a process. So yeah, we got off the ship, got on a shuttle bus. The shuttle bus brought us to the Maritima cruise terminal, where we literally just picked up the bags we had to put on the bus. And then we had to walk quite a ways to the people mover, and then take the people mover one stop to Piazza Roma. And now we're on line one water taxi, going to Rialto Mercato. Rialto Mercato? Mercato.
So ends our little voyage. We hope you've enjoyed our little sampling of our experience on Azamara's Onward. But like anything, there's always things that could be better, like the shower curtains. Although rumor has it, Azamara's been trying different products. And the annoying laundry monopolies. People, one washer, one dryer, please. And there are a couple more things.
We're kind of just a holding area with a couple of chairs. Windows Cafe, where you do your buffet. Their regular coffee is abysmal. I mean, bad. Like, truck stop, middle of nowhere. So today I asked for an Americano, and the gentleman liked the coffee, which was really nice. And that's, thank you. Much better. All the billing fiasco that has been Azamara for the last many, many months for a lot of people, in a sense of frustration and problems. A lot of people will tell you or encourage you that everything will be fine once you're on the boat. And yes, it's a lovely time once you're on the boat, but they still haven't quite got everything organized. So as a result, what I'm finding out now is that yes, we probably have gone over our onboard credit, and I will have a bit of a balance, but it would have been nice to know what that was before I went and spent some extra money, because not everybody can just be blowing cash.
Finally, got our onboard credit. Looked after. And everything is correct now, and we owe a grand total of $9 and change.
Well, while they needed to be pointed out, most issues we encountered were worked out in the end. So from coffee to laundry, room to cabaret, from exotic port to ancient city, this was just a little sample of what an Azamara cruise was for us. And all I can say is, I'm eyeballing that Monaco GP itinerary. We hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to give us a thumbs up.
Agreed.
And please consider clicking on that subscribe button. It really goes a long way to helping us grow this channel. Leave us a comment if you have any questions to share or interesting cruise and travel ideas that we should try. And finally, if you managed to hang in and watch all the way to the end, thank you so very much. If you want to see more, let us know or check out one of the other episodes on our channel. Ciao.